When a man and woman love each other very much, and sometimes not, they end up making a baby. And the woman's body goes through a ton of changes, but then again, so does the man's. Hey there, ladies and gentlemen, Trace here for DNews. Thanks for watching. Pregnancy causes a lot of visible and invisible changes to mom bods, mental, physical, hormonal, emotional, and so on. But the moms aren't alone in this brand new world. Science has finally begun to recognize dads might be going through changes right alongside. In 2007, a study came out describing Couvade syndrome, also known as sympathetic pregnancy. The study followed more than 500 men and found that the majority of the men displayed pregnancy-associated symptoms of morning sickness, stomach cramps, mood swings, and a few even developed swollen stomachs called pseudocyesis. A ton of studies have documented these sympathetic effects, which worsen as the pregnancy progresses, clearing up after the birth. They're not sure exactly what causes Couvade syndrome, but they think it's psychosomatic, or it's caused by the mind. Thus, it's not actually a medical condition, but a psychological one. So though sympathetic pregnancy might be caused by anxiety, attention-seeking behavior, or as a, quote, statement of paternity, as some hypotheses say, there are actual changes men go through during pregnancy. Male marmosets and cotton-top tamarins, primates with similar child-rearing practices to humans, gain as much as 20% of their body weight during their mate's pregnancy, perhaps to store extra energy in preparation of raising their offspring. Studies in humans found that cortisol, which is one of our stress hormones, and prolactin, which is a lactation hormone, spike in men alongside their pregnant ladies. Recently, a study from the University of Michigan found surprising hormonal changes in fathers, which started rather quickly. Within the first 12 weeks of their mate's pregnancy, testosterone and estradiol levels dropped in the dads-to-be, and the drop continued throughout the pregnancy. The researchers admitted that they don't know exactly why, but they expect it has something to do with the changes the woman's body is going through, perhaps to prepare the men as they, quote, transition to fatherhood. Anecdotally, it might be a good thing for testosterone to drop, as it's associated with aggression, risk-taking, and sexual savoir-faire. But curiously, it actually rose in the women during the same period. Estradiol is similar to estrogen, and estrogen in men hasn't been very thoroughly studied. Though scientists think that a drop in estrogen in men makes them show symptoms similar to menopause in women. Decreased bone density, a decline in libido, and fat around their midsection. And finally, we can't talk about fatherhood without mentioning the infamous dad bod. Well, sort of. Men who lived with their child gained 2.6% in their BMI, or an average of 2 kilograms. Men who lived apart from their children still gained 1.5 kilos, or a 2% BMI increase. This is according to a study in the American Journal of Men's Health. They found that lifestyle changes caused weight gain, but could this be explained by a lowering of estradiol levels? Perhaps. Ultimately, most of the studies of pregnancy are lady-facing, which makes all of the sense. But to completely dismiss or ignore men because they're not actually pregnant seems kind of stupid, especially in light of the surprising science that we've seen. Humans evolved two-parent caregiving to give our offspring the best parental resources available, and that does seem to extend pre-birth. So say it with me now, more research is obviously needed. But what do you think about sympathetic pregnancy? Is it real? Have any of you experienced it? We know that some of you out there are parents. So parents, if you have not subscribed to DNews, go sign in and subscribe. Really, you won't regret it, and we'd love to know that you're out there so we can make more videos for you too. Do y'all know some other things about pregnancy, and are you sure they're not myths? Check out this other video where we debunk some tall tales about birthing. Strangers will throw shade at you for being in a sushi restaurant or at Starbucks or on an airplane. Everyone's got opinions, but do they have facts that back them up? Thanks for watching DNews, everybody. Again, please subscribe and let us know down in the comments what you thought.